Welcome to another video from Dr. Locke. I thought I might do a quick video for some of the apprentices out there or some of the people who are new to key cutting. So what we have here is we have our key machine on the bench, and as you can see, it's been used quite a bit. Some of the best housekeeping practices are to keep this machine clean at all times as much as possible, and also lubricated. To stop these jaws from rusting, you need to clean the machine down, take the jaws off, clean them down, and give them a spray with WD-40 and wipe them down with a rag. I'm not going to go to that extent in this video because it's pretty much straightforward. You just take off the top like this. All key machines are the same. This is what it says in the manual. Take off the top, don't lose any of the parts, take it off, give it a good clean on every surface, because when you put this jaw back on, if it's not in there square, you're not going to be cutting a good key. And then basically you put your carriage, you got to clean that too. You got to get right into those nook and crannies, the bottom, the top, every surface. I'm doing this one-handed, that's why it's harder. You get the idea. Put it back on, make sure your jaws are matching. We're on single-sided there and double-sided there, single-sided there and double-sided there. And once it's all nice and clean, you put it back on. To start off with the cleaning process, it's always better to start at the top. So you'd start from the top. There are certain paintbrushes. This is a standard paintbrush. This is one that was on an angle. The angle ones are longer and better because you can kind of get in there. As long as it's a nice big paintbrush where you're staying right away from the buttons in case they switch on or you bump them or something, you know, anything long with a nice handle and a good paintbrush will do it. This one is going in the bin after this, and you can just use a $2 paintbrush. Most importantly, keep your hands away from anything. If you're giving it a full strip down, you might want to take the cord out the back or just turn the power point off. Start from the top, work your way down, all the way down. Certain parts like this one in here, this rod that goes back and forth, most important that you get clean. Doesn't matter how much you clean, you're still going to end up with some sort of swarf inside the machine. It always happens. So the more you clean it, the less chance you're going to get of that, and the less problems you're going to have down the track. If you get swarf and little brass cuttings inside the machine, they can actually short it out and cause you problems and lose your machine down the track. We've been cutting brass on this one here, so you can see the nice gold color, and we've been cutting steel on this machine here. Now, it is a high strength steel. The machine can do it, but what I find is that using steel keys generally wears out the cutter a bit. So I've got one machine for steel and I've got one machine for brass, and I like it that way. This one makes a lot more noise when cutting. Anyway, back to the cleaning process. Once you've gone down from the top and you've cleaned it all down, then you would remove your jaws, because we're moving our way down. You'd spray them, clean every surface, lubricate them with some WD-40 and put them back on. Then you come along with your tray here and just lift that out. Be very careful with this, do not disturb it. Just going to open up my bin, dirty as anything. I've cut a few keys, as you can see, and I'm just going to throw this in on top. And then, look at that big piece that just got away from me. Look at that. All right, then we close it up so no wind will get to it, and then we continue on cleaning underneath the tray. Generally, you'd be doing this about once a day. If you're an apprentice in a shop, you'd be doing this once a day. Not lubricating the jaws, but you would be definitely grabbing the paintbrush once a day and cleaning it down if you're working in a shop. It should be perfect looking like that. Put that tray back in. Now, question, can't I just use the vacuum cleaner? Can't I just use the air tool? No, never use an air tool. You're going to put this brass into the air and it is dangerous. You can get it in your eyes, your hands, all over the place. You're better off just using a paintbrush, keeping it to a minimum, brushing into a tray and putting exactly where it needs to go. Somewhere where it can't be disturbed by the wind in the workshop. Somewhere where it's out of the way and it can go to the recycler at the end of the year. Now, in the old days, there used to be like two cases of beer from a fairly busy shop. You'd collect enough brass to buy two cases of beer for the Christmas party at the end of the year. So it's the right thing to do. It's the cleanest way of doing it. Collect it all up and then take it to the brass recycler. Make sure your container's good and it doesn't spill, because it can be dangerous. Okay, once all my swarf's in there, and these are also quite splintery too. Once all your swarf's in there, you basically throw it away and your machine's ready to go. Turn it back on and your machine's ready to go. Okay, so that's cleaning a key machine, why you do it, how you do it, and when to do it. Leave your comments down below. Thanks for watching.